talk about that punctuation.
Punctuation. What you gonna do, what you gonna say, if you don't know punctuation?
Punctuation marks, they make your writing smart and keep your meaning clear in any situation.
What you gonna do, what you gonna say, if you don't know punctuation?
Punctuation marks, they make your writing smart and keep your meaning clear in any situation. Periods are first on our list of punctuation marks. They end every sentence before a new one starts. If you're using numbers in a list or outline, put one after every number and you will be fine. Next up is the question mark. It's a period with a curl on top. Use it after every question that you write down. And sometimes in Spanish, it's upside down. The punctuation mark that we use the most is called a comma. And that is no joke. If you have to list several things in a row, use a comma to help keep your flow. For example, I have bacon, comma, eggs, comma, cereal, comma, and juice for breakfast.
Period.
Use commas in your address to separate the street from the city and the city from your state. And also when you write down dates like January 2nd, 2008. Phrases and words that describe different terms are set off by commas. Now listen and learn. Music,
comma,
a collection of sounds,
comma,
is the way we get down. Two related ideas hooked together by a comma are called a compound sentence. No need for drama. Punctuation confused me for a long time, but now it's easy cause I learned this rhyme.
What you gonna do, what you gonna say, if you don't know punctuation?
Punctuation marks, they make your writing smart and keep your meaning clear in any situation.
What you gonna do, what you gonna say, if you don't know punctuation?
Punctuation marks, they make your writing smart and keep your meaning clear in any situation. An exclamation point expresses strong feeling, like excitement when somebody is screaming. And close the words of a speaker in quotation marks, they tell you when the talking stops and starts. When you have to break a word into syllables, cause the line that you're on is getting full, use a hyphen. Put a hyphen at the end of one syllable and continue the word on the next line. That's a hyphen. Compound words are also linked with a hyphen, and you need to know them even though you don't use them often, like the number 23 and forget-me-nots.
Punctuation,
punctuation. Often it's cool to make two words into one. An apostrophe gets the job done. Leave out some letters in this action, and what you get is called a contraction. One or two letters in the second word, the apostrophe replaces. Haven't you heard? Cannot becomes can. Now stay with me.
I will becomes I.
And now you see.
What you gonna do, what you gonna say, if you don't know punctuation?
Punctuation marks, they make you writing smart and keep your meaning clear in any situation.
What you gonna do, what you gonna say,
punctuation marks, they make your writing smart and keep your meaning clear in any situation. There are situations when you need to show possession. Apostrophe S is the key to this lesson. Something can belong to a person, place, a thing like Joe's book or the bride's ring. In this case, apostrophe S follows the word, but here's the rest. If the word's last letter is already an S, like Marcus or Jess, just add an apostrophe at the end, and now you've got possession, my friend. And that's using punctuation. This is the stuff you got to know if your writing's gonna flow. So take your time and learn this rhyme and keep hitting the books, and we'll be back with more raw hooks.
What you gonna do, what you gonna say, if you don't know punctuation?
Punctuation marks, they make your writing smart and keep your meaning clear in any situation.
What you gonna do,
punctuation marks, they make your writing smart and keep your meaning clear in any situation.
What you gonna do, what you gonna say,
what you gonna
don't know punctuation?
What you gonna
punctuation marks, they make your writing smart and keep your meaning clear in any situation.
What you gonna do, what you gonna say,
what you gonna